Now let us do a question. Let me read out the question for you. It says AD and BC, they are equal perpendiculars to a line segment AB. Now this is a line segment AB, and AD and BC, they are perpendiculars as well as they are equal to each other, right? Now what do we have to show? We have to show that CD bisects AB. Where is CD? CD is here. This bisects AB. Now what do I mean by bisect? Bisect means dividing it into two equal parts or two equal halves, right? So let me draw the triangle for you. Now this is a triangle, this is point D, A, O, B and C. We are given that these two angles, they are 90 degree, and this side DA is equal to BC. So let me write down the given conditions for you. First of all, we need to show that CD bisects AB. We need to show this statement, right? Now what are the condition that are given to us? Given is AD is equal to BC, right? AD is equal to BC, angle A is equal to angle B is equal to 90 degree, right? This angle A is equal to angle B, which is equal to 90 degree. Now what can I say about angle DOA and angle BOC? Now BA and DC, what are they? They are nothing but two line segments that are intersecting at the point A. So these two, they are nothing but they are vertically opposite angles, and as we already know that vertically opposite angles, they are equal to each other. So I can write angle DOA is equal to angle BOC. Why? Because vertically opposite angles are equal, right? Vertically opposite angles, they are equal to each other. So what all I am getting from these two triangles? In triangle, let's say DAO, and triangle, let's say BCBO, right? In triangle DAO and CBO, what do we have? We have angle A is equal to angle B, right, which is given to us. We have angle DOA is equal to angle BOC because of vertically opposite angles, and then we have AD is equal to BC, which was given to us. These two conditions, they were given to us, and this condition we found out, right? So what is this? This is nothing but AAS, that is angle side congruence rule. So I can write that both the triangles, triangle DAO, it is congruent to triangle CBO, right? Triangle DAO is congruent to triangle CBO. Now let us give a check whether we have written the sequence in the right order. Let's see. I can say that AD is equal to BC. Now let's verify. We have, we'll call it 1, 2, 3, we'll call this 4, 5, 6. So how can I get AD? I can get AD right here by 2, 1. Now 2, 1 is AD, right? 2 dash 1 is AD. So from the other side, I should get 5 dash 4, right? From the other side, I should get 5 dash 4. Now what is 5 dash 4? 5 dash 4 is nothing but BC. And that was what I needed, right? So the sequence in which we have written the congruence condition is definitely correct, right? So we have verified this. Now what we can conclude, we can say that because the triangles are congruent, all the sides of this triangle would be equal to all the sides of this triangle, right? So let me write it down for you. I can say AO is equal to BO, right? AO is equal to BO. 2, 3 is equal to 5, 6, right? Now, what is the reason for this? I already explained it. This is called CPCT. What do we mean by CPCT? Corresponding parts of congruent triangles, right? Because the triangles are congruent, so the corresponding parts would be equal to each other. You already know this. This is corresponding parts of congruent triangles, right? So this is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Now AO is equal to BO, so I can simply say that CD bisects AB into two equal halves, right? Because AO is equal to BO. So this is, we have proved what we required to do in the statement, right? So let us look at another question.